Hey guys, this is Morgan. Exams are finally over, and today I'll be sharing about how to catch a green ant without relying on just luck. You may have heard YouTubers telling you to go out early in the morning and to look at the floor to find green ants. However, if you try this in Singapore or in most tropical places, chances are you will fail. And due to our strict laws here, we are unable to import or dig up colonies. I spent months waking up early in the morning before school, hoping that I would find a green ant. But of course, it did not work. Here's why. Firstly, the temperature in Singapore is super hot, being up to 35 degrees Celsius a day. Unless the ant has a good reason to fly out during the day, such as being heavily reliant on eyesight, it is simply disadvantageous to do so. Not only do they have a high chance to burn up, but there are also many predators around, such as birds. Even species such as the black sugar ants, with adaptations to reflect UV light from the sun and thus survive in the heat, they may still choose to fly in the night due to the predators. And so, the solution to catch more green ants is to hunt at night. But of course, there are other factors to take into consideration, such as what day to hunt and where to hunt. If this is the first ant hunting tutorial that you've watched, you may be wondering why do green ants even fly out of the nest in the first place. Wouldn't it be such a risk for the colony in the wild, and shouldn't they be hiding deep underground instead? And since when do queen ants even have wings? Well, the answer to this is that the queen ants that you will find are not exactly queen ants. Not yet at least. You see, queen ants from matured colonies, meaning big colonies with excess food, actually produce female and male alates, which are basically the reproductive ants. During a nuptial flight, also known as a mating day, these ants will fly up into the night sky, following the moonlight to find alates from other colonies to mate with. This is to ensure a varied gene pool so that the ants have a higher chance of survival over the years. So now that we know what's a nuptial flight and why queen ants fly out of the nest, we have to find out when and where this will take place. Let's start with when. Nuptial flights typically take place after a heavy rainstorm that lasts for at least 3 hours and ends at least 3 hours before the sunset. However, do remember that this is not true for all species. Some species will fly in the morning or even the following night. And as for where, remember how I said alates will follow the moonlight? Well, in modern day Singapore, that is usually not the case. Singapore's light pollution has caused ants to mistake our light as the moonlight that they should be following. As a result, they tend to gather at bright areas. Remember those flying insects you see flying around your lights at night? That's right. They're probably alates. But Morgan, there is light all over Singapore.
Very well.
Where should I go? Well, that's true, but there are also ants all around Singapore. Try out various hunting places such as void decks, basketball courts, or even gas stations. As I like to say, the best way to improve your ant keeping skills is to learn from your own experience as well from experience of other people. I strongly recommend joining a local ant group so that you know when nuptial flights happen, and you can share with them your own experience as well. So now that you know when and where the green ants might appear, it is time to search for them. But before that, you may be wondering, what do we need to bring to catch green ants? It's actually quite simple. All you need is just some containers. But there are also many equipment that could help you as well, such as a light backpack, a laminated card, some cotton, torch lights, and maybe some drinks. I actually learned this life hack from my friend. Sometimes I like to use this medicine container to go and catch ants. It is small and compact and has many compartments, allowing you to catch the most ants possible with the least amount of space required. You may be wondering why I'm using containers instead of test tubes. This is because I find that most test tubes, especially glass ones, are way too fragile. When hunting, there is a very high chance that you might accidentally drop your containers or test tube. A broken test tube does not only mean that your ants might escape, but other people might accidentally step on the broken glass and injure themselves. Even if you use a plastic test tube, which is less likely to break, it is still less effective than a container due to the small opening. So now that you have the knowledge of ant hunting, here's a video of me hunting for queen ants.
Hi guys, Morgan here. So this is my first live ant hunting video, and also the first time you're gonna see half my face. So unfortunately today, there probably will not be too many ants considering that it rained like a little bit too early, like in the morning. But I'll see what I can find. So here's the time lapse. Oh yeah, and I'm sorry for the bad audio, there's like a lot of cars here.
So originally I actually wanted to have a live chat with you guys while hunting, but due to the many cars there, the audio is practically unhearable, so here's what it sounds like. Yeah, pretty bad, right? So since I was unable to have a live chat with you while hunting, I'm probably gonna have a live chat while voicing over this. And here's where I found my first queen ant that night. Hey guys, we got our first queen ant over here. It's a Fridolin Hava queen, so here's how I'm gonna catch it. One hand, yeah, okay. So I use the container and hurry on the top like this. And slide my amazing animal kaiser cut underneath it. As you can see, that did not go very well. So if you were unable to hear what I was saying at that time, I was actually trying to describe how I would catch a queen ant. But due to my lack of my left hand, since I was recording my phone, I was unable to do it properly and the queen just disappeared. Well, no worries, because in a few minutes time I actually found another queen ant, or at least what I thought was a queen ant.
Yeah, I thought that would be, and it's
some lizard food, I guess. Oh wait, as you can see, I am completely blind. Also, if you're wondering, I actually don't live at this HDB estate. I just came here after dinner because I needed to record an end video and there were ants flying that day. Definitely a bad choice because of the traffic here. Usually the floors at bright areas like this, you'll have some queen ant. But not that day, because as you can see, there were literally nothing down there. But fortunately, in a few minutes time, I actually found not one but two Crematogaster bonensis queen, which is a species that I currently do not own. Although I'm quite sure they are infertile after watching them over a few days. But hey, at least I got to take some nice pictures and videos of them.
I think those are Crematogaster queens. I can't really see from here, but let's just catch them. Normally I would slide a card underneath, but my left hand is being used to record, so that's a problem. I guess I'll just wait for it to record and do it. And perfect.
And now I decided to catch the second Crematogaster queen, this time with both hands, so it's not impossible. Also, here's a life hack for you guys out there. You should always bring a sibling along if you want to catch queen ants. Not only can they record videos for you, but if the queen ant is too high for you to reach, you can also use them as a stepping stool. Nah, just kidding, don't do that. Don't abuse your siblings.
Okay, so today was a decent hunting session. I only got two queens, but at least these two are queens that I've never had before. Well, I had before, but I don't have now. So yeah, that's a good thing. So I don't think I've said it yet, but these queens are actually Crematogaster bonensis, which is a type of acrobat ant, if I'm not wrong. Oh yeah, by the way, the queen ant that I lost just now was a Fridolin Hava queen, which is a species that I currently have.
So the plan that day was actually for me to go home, make a setup for the Crematogaster queen and take some nice videos of it. But then I realized that if there's a nuptial flight happening outside my house, it probably means that my Campanotus oriventris colony will have their nuptial flights in the house again. Yeah, cleaning is fun. And now you're ready to hunt for your first queen ant. There are more advanced methods of hunting for ants, but I'll be covering them in another video. If you're still unsure about what to prepare before starting ant heaping, do check out the first tutorial I made down in the description below, as well as a full playlist of ant heaping tutorials that I'll be adding on with future videos. If you found this helpful, do leave a like and subscribe. It's free and you can always change your mind later. And do leave a comment about the queens that you have found using this method, and share this with your friends who have troubles finding their first queen ant. So good luck in finding your queen ants, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!